So I went and did some little bit of research and was looking at Buddhist texts and so on, and even Vedantic texts. Let me give you a little bit of terminology of these descriptions of the inconceivable, immortal, eternal consciousness. So immortal means amar in Sanskrit. Amara, infinite is ananta. Irreducible and imperceivable means beyond the senses. Atincha, unmanifest, avyakta. Ajara, ageless and timeless, not subject to decay. Akshara, beyond all sensory experiences. Inherently incomprehensible, non-physical, amvita. And these all describe how consciousness is differentiating and currently also recreating everything that was born in the incomprehensible past. So if you subscribe to the Big Bang Theory, then the Big Bang Theory is the description from the point of view of naive realism, and it is an objective description through human modes of knowing and experience. Objective. And it starts with a singularity, a point of zero volume, infinite density that contains in potential all the matter, energy, information that will ultimately manifest as the universe. Turn that around to a consciousness model, and the singularity becomes a point of zero volume and infinite possibilities. And consciousness knows itself without being embodied. It knows itself. Humans call atoms and molecules and starscapes and the whole thing. That's a human description of a human mode of knowing and experience. But the universe had modes of knowing and experience because it started with pure consciousness or cosmic consciousness. And that cosmic consciousness knew itself as modes of knowing and experience. We can call them qualia, qualities of experience, without being embodied. The embodiment came much later, and the embodiment created actually the multiverses that we speak of as modes of knowing and experience in organisms, a form of biocentrism. So I know this is a little difficult to comprehend, but as long as we understand that the consciousness model actually explains some of the gaps that we don't know, because those gaps are modes of knowing and experience that are not comprehensible to the human mind. The human mind, infinite with the finite, I mean, human mind, finite with a finite brain as its instrument for modes of knowing and experience, cannot comprehend the non-embodied modes of knowing and experience, which exist only in consciousness, even prior to its modes of knowing and experience through embodied consciousness. New theory of cosmic creation. Let's call it the consciousness model of creation. You know, I'm speculating with you based on ideas that come from deep reflection and transcendence, and therefore may not find validity with current scientific thinking. But remember, scientific thinking is also modes of knowing and experience in a species-specific consciousness that we call Homo sapiens. Reality is not only stranger than we think it is, it's stranger than we can think. Last night I sat down and wrote all these Sanskrit words that are already there. Irreducible Atincha, infinite Ananta, immortal, non-physical, invisible, Adishya, Ajara, ageless, Akshara, indestructible, that is Avyaya, imperishable, and Ashisha, perfect, complete symmetry. So others have thought about this as well. Take care.